last week and rules as we all were here first time round. So welcome to the Planning and Highways Committee meeting, 22nd of June. Item one, apologies for absence.
No apologies, there's a full house, 9 members.
Item two, disclosure of interest, to deal with any disclosure by members of any disclosed pecuniary interests and interests other than pecuniary interests as defined under the C4 Town Council Code of Conduct and Localism Act 2011 in relation to matters on the agenda. Am I so joined?
I've got to sit on this, I feel I'm the only one, I might, no, Council Lambert.
Which one are we talking about?
Right, so who will we go first?
Go that way, good.
No, I don't know, I'm just putting my hand up.
Oh, what?
Council Freeman.
LW170435 appertains to my property, so I'll make myself absent when it's discussed.
We need the meeting, thank you.
Same as me.
Council Lizzie Freeman.
Thank you, Madam. I'm going to offer a non-pecuniary interest on item LW170404, 104 Clement Road. The actual applicant is known to me, is candidate for East Ward, and I'm a member of the Bunch Committee, so I will not speak about him.
Councillor Coleman.
Yeah, thanks, Chair. So, the same as Councillor Goodwin.
Mm-hmm.
I won't be speaking on that. Also, same with Councillor Freeman's one as well. And also, LW170463, 28 Simbridge Way, that's in the same street as myself, so I'll get involved with that, Chair.
Councillor Coleman.
Thank you.
Councillor Freeman.
Thank you.
Same as Councillor Bourne, LW170404.
I knew there'd be a query about Councillor Freeman's application. You could obviously all declare an interest being an acquaintance of Councillor Freeman, both councillors through the council. That would sort of take away the right that they have as applicants, or she has as an applicant, to have her application considered by the town council. I think in this situation, you need, obviously the relationship needs to be acknowledged, but I think the fairest thing to do is to attempt to be objective, to carry out your role as councillors responsible for commenting on applications, that the minute or the response should include the fact that the applicant is a member of the committee, but to attempt to be as objective as possible. It's dealt with in the public, everything's transparent. If you feel that you can't be objective on it, if you feel that your comments are inevitably sort of going to be influenced, then don't take part in the debate and don't vote. But as I say, I think it would be in a way penalising the two councillors concerned if you were to sort of wash your hands of the whole thing and pass it on to Seaford, considering that you're not actually making a decision,
yes.
You're making a response. Obviously, if this were the Planning Applications Committee at Lewis District Council, then you would have to apply, there would be an application on your behalf, if you like, for a special dispensation to enable you to take part in the debate and vote on it. Because you see, if at district council level everyone declared an interest, there's nobody else to make a decision except the officers. And you can't have the officers making a decision in this case, because on an application like this, justice and transparency require that it's dealt with at a public meeting rather than at a desk in the office with the two applicants looking over the officer's shoulder, possibly. So it's a bit of a quandary. It's a bit of a quandary for you, and obviously more of a quandary at district level, but you're not at that level, thankfully.
Usually district, if it's more staff, we'll put a straightforward application which will have no problems with passing. It comes to the committee because...
Just because of the transparency, yeah. So, you're merely commenting, and it's up to each individual councillor, but if you feel you can look at it objectively and make an objective response, then you should go ahead and do that. If you don't, if you can't, then you should just decline and not take part. If any of you've got any queries, do you want to withdraw that declaration?
No, because it's my position to fire up the ladder. It's more
I see. Good member of the district council.
If, well, yeah.
Yeah. I'll come to you. Yeah. 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 Sorry.
So probably
better
to you.
So yeah, I'd like to.
I'll just have personal interest in with the Freemans in there.
Yes,
that's fine. I just don't take part.
Yeah, personal.
Just a personal.
That will be declared. Everyone has a personal interest.
Yeah.
But
it's not.
Yeah.
No, nothing to worry. Still not part of that.
And also that I'm a member of the Lewis District Council Planning Committee. Item 3, public participation. In accordance with Standing Order 3 and Seaport Town Council policy, members of the public will be entitled to speak on general issues concerning this committee or non-planning application matters at this point. People wishing to speak on planning applications may do so immediately before each planning application. Any members of the public like to speak at this moment on non-planning? Item 4, planning applications for weekend in the 5th of May. LW/17/0323, Beachside, Cricketfield Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application?
I'm probably the only person who lives in Cricketfield Road. So I just walked around the property just now. That's all I can say.
Can I have your name?
Yes, it's Michael Sonyaes. MICHAELSON. YEATES AH. I live 55 Group of Room.
Okay.
All right, now, it's just because I've been picked this up today. Just walk around the property inside, on the outside. I'm just a minute.
Have you any views?
Well, I haven't seen the actual plan. Four buildings. I mean, I talked to one person next door. He's going to be they're going to be skinny houses. I wrote one in the back. They've got no guards at all. It's about that far from the fence. So I've yet to see the plans.
We have to view all plans online now, I'm afraid.
Yeah, I can only have access to the library.
Well, the design of them is very good. It fits in beautifully with the ones further up the road, but it does look very, very cramped. I think three houses would be better there. And as the gentleman said, there's actually no back garden apart from seated playing field. But the design, I think, is good. They just look so. Then, you know, people happen to squeeze smaller and smaller these days, aren't they? So I'd be inclined, I don't know how I feel about it yet.
Okay. Sorry, Chair, because I don't like the unseen in the contest. Councillor,
I don't know about that. Councillor.
Well, I've got couple of things to say, really. I do think it is overcrowding and overdevelopment with four, there's too many. But I, whatever we decide, I do think we ought to make the comment that we're, it's another loss of a care home. And like it or not, they're badly needed receivers. We've got lots of residents who need nursing and care homes, and we're losing them faster than we're gaining them. So I do think we need to make that point, that it's a loss of a facility. And presumably, lots of jobs as well for people that work in that. But I would say it's overcrowding. It's four is far too many for that site.
I'd like to second Councillor Lowe's proposal for development. I agree with everything she said, actually. I think it's very sad that when we're so desperate for care homes in the current environment, that here goes another way. I think three properties there rather than four would probably be more appropriate. I share Councillor Lindsay Freeman's view that it's probably in keeping with the area, particularly the development at the staying end of the road. But I think it's overdeveloped, and I think we've got to be very careful in Seaford, because the way development is going, the character of the town is likely to be destroyed. Is too strong, but it's likely to be violated a little bit. You know, we have to develop the Stain Road, where site homes have got four bungalows, two semi-detached bungalows on one plot. And again, it's getting a court into a pipe pot, and before we know it, Seaford way, and we don't want Seaford to look that way. On the other hand, we have to be cognizant of this district council's position, and the developer's going to appeal, and the public has something to pay for that appeal if we, in any event, if it goes to appeal. So I think we should, I'd like to second the proposal for overdevelopment in the hope that we can end up with three on that plot rather than four.
So obviously, you haven't voted on it yet, but the motion would be overdevelopment, but would you also want to say that the design is appropriate? But that three, it would be appropriate to have three units on that site rather than four. Because I mean, it sort of gives more balance to the view. But also, I mean, you can't refuse an application like this on the basis that the rest home is needed. But you can still put forward the comment that the loss of the rest home is regrettable. Even though it's not directly related to the application before you. So I mean, if you want to put those comments, then you've sort of given the district council your full view.
Maybe our parking is an issue
as
well.
Yeah, right. And so,
we have got city council policy about losing businesses. Basically, this is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, normally it's in the town centre where we don't like to see businesses go on the ground floor, but find the developing above. But I don't know.
Does there need to be a change of use?
Well, no, the fact that you're applying for houses sort of implies that it's a change of use as well. It's sort of all tied in one package.
Yeah, just another note, Chair, that that's an notorious flood area in that one as well. Sorry, I've got no good facts. It's a flood area, flood area. So is it acceptable that 4 points is there? Point to note. Around council lathing. The flood, it's a flood plain.
There's more site coverage there, obviously. It is nicely level.
I mean, if we think it's relevant, I don't mind including that, but
notorious, but
although the property's already there.
I just like to comment on the applicant's notes related to this application. That owing to enhanced regulations for elderly care homes, they need to be considered modification, and it's just not financially viable. questions?
Cost of knocking it down and rebuilding it. It doesn't line up.
Right, so we've got proposal on the table, objective of overdevelopment.
Potential flood risk, regretting the loss of another local business, a care home, but that it's accepted that the design fits in with the terrace up the road, but the three houses would be more appropriate than you know, four is overdevelopment, but three houses might be more appropriate.
Okay. Right. Can I have a show of hands of objective on
the ground? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 in favour.
Those against?
That's carried.
Abstaining.
Carried by abstention. Yes, apologies for missing that one off. They've extended the consultation period to tomorrow to make sure that those comments get back straight away. Just for one reason or another, just got missed off the list.
Thank you. Planning applications for weekend the 26th of May. LW/17/0376, land adjoining 91 High Crescent. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee. Councillor Gordon?
Yeah, I propose that we support the application.
Councillor
Ackman? I'd like to second that proposal, but subject to the Environment Agency contamination report being complied with.
LW/17/0404, 104 Claremont Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Welcome to the committee. Councillor Lowe?
I think it's obviously tidy enough and improving an existing structure, so no objection.
Can I just
second
it? Can I have a show of hands for supporting this application?
1, 2, 3, 4. That's unanimous. The other councillors have declared an interest.
Yep. Yes.
LW/17/0406, 26 Corsica Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee. Councillor Lowe?
It's obviously a matter of variation and making it a smaller scheme, so I don't think we'd have any reason to object to that. No objection.
Can I second
Councillor
Lowe? I
second
that on
the
same grounds.
Okay.
Okay.
Councillor Gordon?
No, she's second.
And can I have a show of hands of support in this application?
1, 2, 3, 4. It's unanimous.
LW/17/0415, 76 Vale Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee. Councillor Goodham?
Thank you, Chair. Yes, I would like to support this application.
Thank you. Is that one second? Any other comments?
Just say about Vale Road, obviously, it's always a mixture of properties in that particular. Historic road, anyway. Like it's one of the early roads in Seaford. People don't know that on the way to Alverston. And yes, it's a good tidying up exercise there for that particular property. Yes.
Thank you. Can I have
a
show of hands supporting this application?
That's supported unanimously.
Planning applications with the weekend of the 2nd of June. LW/17/0373. Crowley, Cookmere Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee. Councillor
Lowe? It's a large plot and it doesn't seem accessible, so I've got no objection.
Second that on the same grounds.
Thank you. Can I have the show of hands for supporting this application? LW RW/17/0399/23 Rookery Way. Any members of the public like to comment on this? Open to the committee.
Just to say, I've received an objection direct, sent direct to the council, which I've passed on to the district council, but won't appear online because it's only just been received. Lady at the rear of the property who lives at 2 Rochford Way, she's 88 years old and is housebound. And she said there have been a lot of extensions at the property already. And she considers she'll lose most of her view from her bungalow if the development goes ahead. And she hates to object to other people's plans, but in this case, she feels she has a right to do so. So she objects, and I pass that on to Lewes District Council. But you'll note, if you've looked at the plans, the gardens are quite lengthy, so it's a difficult objection to sustain, but it still has, you know, should be reported, as I say, because it doesn't appear online.
Councillor Foreman.
Yes, I propose to support this. And a pitch roof going down, I can't see how it can have that much of an effect on the visual. Yeah. I would propose to support that fashion chair, because the pitch roof on there wouldn't have improved their vision.
Okay, did you want to speak, Councillor
Hammond? Yes, I'm supporting the application. I'm just trying to picture Rochford, the one behind it. Is it on a slope that way? So the lady who objects, even though she's thinks she's missing a view, is she not really?
She's on rising ground, isn't she?
Yeah,
she's slightly elevated.
Yeah.
So,
although you've got steps going up to the property 23 Rookery Way,
yeah,
but they have already built on top. So they're really sort of not extending outwards or upwards.
They're filling it in, aren't they?
Yeah,
they're
sort of
so
really
I'm
built,
happy.
Yeah.
Mm.
The pitch roof is the front porch. Is the rear extension, does that have a pitch roof as well, the rear extension? Is it flat roof?
It's flat.
Because if it's a flat roof, then they've obviously considered the issue regarding loss of view as well. Otherwise, presumably, they don't have a pitch roof.
It's sort of like
a balcony. Like a balcony, yeah. So I think I'd second that proposal.
Any more comments?
Yeah.
Have a show of hands for supporting this application.
That's unanimous.
RW/17/0400 23A Sutton Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee. Councillor Lyons first.
I'd like to support this really. It seems it's already a dental surgery on the ground floor, and if I read it right, it's going to give an extra surgery and still retain the residential flat in the property itself, and I would support it.
RW/17/0412 36 Corrie Lane. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee. Councillor
Hammond. Support this. It covers up the port area effectively of that particular property, so then there's no problem with it at all.
I second
it. Thank you. I can have a show of hands for supporting this application. RW/17/0467 Links Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee.
I support it.
Councillor.
I see no reason to decline it. I will support it.
Mm-hmm. Councillor. Thank you. And can I have show of hands for supporting this application? RW/17/0425 3 Clifftops, Clift Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee. So Goodman?
I just thought that.
LW/17/0427 15B Heathville Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee. Councillor Borman.
Yeah, thank you. I'd actually propose not to support this. There's a lot of complaints there from the neighbours about the trees and the depth of the area, and they've already started to close down. Which is, I'm not sure if they're even allowed to do that.
Yes, I second Councillor Borman's proposal to not support the application. Some years ago, when the cottage development 15B was applied for, they at that time applied to put in a 15C as well as a 15B, but it was turned down. 15B was only agreed to on the basis of the trees lining the lane, and the there was some very significant and dogmatic correspondence with regard to maintenance of those trees for privacy and soundproofing purposes. And as Councillor Borman says, some of them have already been removed, and so they're already a breach of their existing planning. I can't see how another building there could possibly be acceptable. So I object in fairly strong terms.
There's a specific Lewis local plan policy against what they call tandem or backland development that's been saved from the old local plan. Is referred to in the statement in support that the applicants put in, that is considered to comply with that. But obviously, if you wanted to strengthen your objection, you wanted to refer to that policy, which is ST4 in the local plan. It's a sort of general policy against backland and town development where it impinges on the amenities of neighbouring residents, etc. Then, as I say, if you wanted to add that, then you would make it
any other comments? So can I show of hands objecting to this application?
I'll also refer to the concern about the trees. It's a non-compliance with that previous condition. To that in response as well, sort of strengthen it even more.
Thank you. So that's unanimous. LW/17/0458, land adjacent to 19 West End Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee.
Thank you, Chair. Yes, I'd like to support this application, and the houses that they've sent through on the internet are very much in keeping, and I think it's nice to be able to fill in that space and have something else at home. So therefore, I'd like to support this
weekend in the 9th of June. LW/17/0390 Sutton Lees Eastbourne Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Councillor
Latham. Thank you, Madam Chair. I was amazed to see this application. SI Homes, I believe, already have approval for development there, and it seems that they are determined to squeeze even more onto a relatively small plot. The original application, LW160491, I think called for four semi-detached units at the front of the plot and five, two or three bedrooms at the rear. Now they want six, two or three bedrooms at the rear. So a total of 10 units on that plot seems quite extraordinary to me. And my concern expressed earlier with regard to Seaford, the character of Seaford being changed by type of development that's permitted, is actually magnified several fold by this application. And therefore I would propose that we do not support it.
The approval is for three bungalows at the rear and two with the same. It hasn't altered the frontage development.
No.
It's just replaced three bungalows with two pairs of semi-detached houses.
Yes.
Yeah, so it's four units replacing three bungalows.
Yes. Yes, that's right. Mm-hmm. There was one bungalow on that plot before. And here we are with four semi-detached units and six.
I support something that Councillor Latham says. It's far too overcrowded. Yes. And also, that was a very busy road up there, so it's got a lot more traffic.
Unfortunately, I disagree with councillors here. I do support the application. That is a very big site up there. And the way they proposed it, I think, is acceptable. And you know, there are high standard homes that he builds. And if you look down the road where the Tudor house used to be, that is pretty much, you know, it is going to be in keeping the air and time. So I think it's all the support anyway. We'll get something like that. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. I mean, my only comment is, as he's already started a lot of all that on that road, it's interesting at this late stage he's wanting to sort of amend it. So it's just a shame he couldn't get it right originally. That's the only reason why I'm sort of make a comment. So,
so we've got on the table for objecting to this application.
Thanks.
So we objected on
overdevelopment that well, you can acknowledge that it's got consent for three bungalows at the rear, and that four units at the rear is considered to be overdevelopment. Mm.
So, can I have a show of hands of objecting on this application?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Those going.
This is supporting the application.
Yeah.
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 You're
against.
You're against.
It's complicated. So
yeah.
Carried 6-1.
Thank you. Thank you. LW-170435 Holm Cottage, Morris Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee.
Councillor Goodman.
Thank you.
Second.
Councillor
Sargent. Any other? I mean, I can't see any problem with it. I mean, I know we're talking about a couple of fellow councillors here, but you know, it's tidy up, it's facing the right way, the Conservatives, and it's great, so I see no problem at all.
Yeah, in the circumstances, if you are supporting the application, it might be appropriate just to add a few comments, you know, as to why you support it,
rather than
the fact that it's who it is,
right.
that it doesn't project further than the existing front extension.
That's right, it doesn't.
Yeah,
it's in line with the building.
Basically, Morris Road is a private road.
Yeah.
The houses up both sides of them are all different types of houses.
Yeah.
So, you know, having a big conservatory, but one that's just a bit out from their front door.
Mm.
Their front door is on the side.
It's fine.
So it's just to add a few comments would be would be appropriate, I think. So
LW/17/0439, 28 St Peter's Road. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Welcome to the committee. Councillor Borman?
Yeah, totally support this application.
I'll second that, Chairman.
Thank you. Can I have a show of hands of support to this application? That's unanimous. LW/17/0446 1 Richmondson Way. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? To the committee, Councillor
Cooper. Thank you, Chair. Actually, it's in my road, it's a fresh house in my road. I don't actually know the people, but I fully support the application. There's no problem with the trees and the others in the come over there. No problem.
Thank you, Councillor
Borman.
LW/17/0463 28 Sixports Way. Any members of the public like to comment on this application? Open to the committee.
Thank you, Chair. Yes, I'd like to support the application. I find nothing wrong with it.
I'm assuming that you'll want me to reiterate the council's objection on the appeal that's mentioned at the bottom. It's a written representation appeal that comments due by in the next few days that there was quite a strong objection to both the first proposals and the amended proposals. So I assume you want me to repeat those comments on the appeal. Just another point of information, since this list was put together, I've received notification that the one Little Place Lane application has been approved as well in the delegated powers. That'll be on the next list.
Thank you.